Good morning and welcome to Friday. We are just getting going now and it is time to set up the C-17. And so I gotta get that ready and the flight test crew is gonna come and talk to me about it and shoot some video. And then we're gonna take it out and fly it before the wind picks up. So stay tuned.
Deep breaths.
Well, we just flew the C-17 and I can breathe again. I gotta say thank you to Stu here for running video for me, and thank you to my dad for helping out with checklist and keeping everything
in tactical support.
Yeah, everything. Oh man, I seriously had the biggest exhale when I landed. It could not have gone better. I'm so thrilled. You'll see video of it on flight test, whatever video that they do. They did a whole segment on it. But I'll put some video in here from what Stu got of the takeoff and a few passes and landing. So, whew. That was worth the drive all by itself. And now I'm gonna take a break, rest my voice a little bit, and maybe finish building the Super Bee that I got last night. So, yeah, stay tuned.
Somebody looks like they're having a good time.
I needed a break after that C-17 flight, so I finished off the Super Bee. Dan Sponholz design. Dan, this is my Angry Bee.
So tell me about it. What are you making it that makes it angry?
Well, the angriest part are the RS-2205 2600 kV red bottoms, powered by a 6-cell. And so I've added a few contours to make it my own. And yeah, it's gonna be fun.
I can't wait to see it fly.
All right, Dan Sponholz, this is for you. This is the Angry Bee.
Wait, what'd you do to the tail?
I added a little strake here. I just gave it a little personal form.
Very cool.
Oh, dude, that thing's a butter, man.
So what do you have to say, Ben?
I am happy with this.
Come on, do another low pass.
We just need a new prop and we're good.
That's good.
It's the giant quad.
Get the parachute, guys! Get the parachute, guys! Get up! Get it going crazy. Super tight, super tight. As tight as you possibly can get it.
Megan, you might want to move back.
Oh,
and he is up. Let's give it up for Ian.
Something's gonna happen. All right. And he commits. Nice, Ian.
Yeah, so, which is kind of nice because we built bands here with the help of Max.
C-17 flyover this time. Yeah, it is. You lost him behind the trees. There he is. All right, that's what we needed before. None of this C-5 stuff. I mean, C5s are all right, you know, if you need to carry something really, really, really long, but, you know, yes, I'm biased. Good evening, it is the end of Friday, and it was a good day. Got a successful C-17 in the morning, and then took a break, finished off my Super B, or my Angry B. Thanks, Dan, great design. I had a lot of fun messing it up, but it flew awesome. I flew it a couple of times, three times actually, I think, and it just was a head turner every time. So that was a ton of fun. And I did get to fly A4 again today. So we'll try and get the C-17 again in the air tomorrow morning. And then tomorrow is the pylon race. So looking forward to that tomorrow as well. And then what else? Oh, Nate flew his 90-inch wing in the dark. You just saw that on the clips. Did not go so well because it's super windy right now. And that big wing was just getting blown around like none other. But still look really cool. I'm looking forward to posting some pictures of that. Probably put some of those in his thread. So he did a really cool job outlining with some EL wire. It was really cool. But now I gotta cut this down and upload it so you can all watch it and then go to bed. So have a good Friday. See you Saturday.